Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Well, we're back here in Excel 2007. Spent last week talking about Excel 2010. Great question today sent in by Terry from Springfield, Missouri. Now, Terry has sponsored a number of seminars out in Springfield, and so when this question came in, I said, oh, this is a great question because it deals with how to do a simple little macro and put it in your personal macro workbook. Terry says, hey, I really like, you know, if we type 123 and press enter, it goes down. And in my books and in the seminars, I talk about how we can change that. Go into Excel options, go back to advanced, and we can change that to be right. Click OK. And so now I press 123 and it goes to the right. Terry says, I would like a one-click way to change from right to down. And I said, all right, we can do that, but we're going to do that with a macro stored in your personal macro workbook. So let's do this. We go to View, we go to Macros, record a macro, and I'm going to say that it is the Move Down. I'm not going to assign it to a shortcut key. Leave it in the personal macro workbook. Click OK. Now, while the macro recorder is recording, I'm going to go to Excel Options, go to Advanced, and change this to Down. Good enough. Click OK. Now, we want to stop recording, so we come down here to the Stop Recording button. All right, first macro is done. Let's do that again. Macros, Record Macro. This one is going to be called Move Right. Click OK. Back to Excel Options, back to Advanced, and change this to Right. Click OK, and then stop. All right, so now we have our two macros, but we need a good way to run those, and we're going to add them to the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, your Quick Access Toolbar might be up here next to the Office button, or you might have moved it down below the ribbon. Either way, right-click and choose Customize, and then in the Customize dialog box, we're going to go to Macros, and find our macro. So there's Move Down and Move Right. I'm going to add both of those to the Quick Access Toolbar. I'm going to customize them both. Let's see here. We're going to modify this. We have 144 different icons and beautifully Move Down. There is a down arrow. Excellent. And we'll even change the tooltip to say down after enter. Click OK. And then on Move Right, we'll modify that one and use the right arrow. Tooltip will be right after enter. Click OK. All right, now here's the real test. So we're going to choose down, go 123, press enter, 123, enter, 123, enter. We'll choose right, 123, enter, 123, enter, 123, enter. So there you have it. A setting that generally would take you a couple of mouse clicks. If it's something that you're switching back and forth for all the time, the macro recorder will do a great job for you. Very easy to record a couple of very quick, they're really one-line macros, and then assign those to buttons on the Quick Access Toolbar. So now you have that access. So there you have it. I want to thank Terry for sending in that great question to get us started back on our week returning to Excel 2007. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.